Don't you just hate it when you're trying to film and all you can hear is this in the background? Holly, go to sleep. You're meant to be nocturnal. Hi guys, so today I am filming the what happened to my animal family video. It's not really an exciting video, I'm really sorry. My channel has been so depressing lately, but I kind of need to get this video out so you guys can understand that I'm not killing off my animals. I promise, I'm not. But first I thought we could open my advent calendar because this video is a little bit depressing, so I thought that maybe if we opened my advent calendar, it'd make it a bit more festive and a bit more cheerful and not so daunting to make. Here's my advent calendar. I got the Milky Way one. I always like white chocolate, so let's open it. Do you know what? Two is always so hard to find. Ah, look. I got a letter to Santa today. A crack on this video. Basically, I've already explained in another video what happened to Latte, so if you guys want to know what happened to Latte, I'll leave the link below for that video so you can go and check that video out and know what happened to him. Because I think losing Latte was such a big blow to me and the animal family that everyone's wondering what the hell happened. So I've already explained that part of Latte in the other video, so go and check it out. It's down there. Just click on the link. Recently we lost Remy, and I've just added a video today that says that we lost Pepper that no one knew about. I have kept everyone in the dark and I'm so sorry about that. But I'm just going to crack on with this and explain to you what happened to Remy first, because she died before Pepper and just after Latte. I can only apologise now for how terrible I look. I'm so sorry. I look awful. My hair's a mess. I've got like hardly any makeup on and I'm only wearing lip balm. So sorry about that. Remy had a tumour that was diagnosed a month before she passed away. Basically what happened is I found a lump on the back of her leg, like, you know where their bums are, and it was like just there on her leg, and I noticed it probably about 2 months before she died, and I decided to take her to the vet straight away because obviously I know rats are prone to tumors. But I prayed and prayed that it was just a hernia or a cupcake in her leg or something, because, you know, we all think that our animals are going to be living forever, and the sad reality is they don't live forever. They die, and it's such a sad feeling that if you don't have animals, you'll never ever understand the concept of how sad it is to lose a pet, especially one of my fur babies. They're like my children. So after I took her to the vets, they took her weight, they done some tests on her and stuff, they confirmed it was a tumour, and they offered me all sorts of things, ranging from an autopsy of the tumour, so they would like put her to sleep and then take a little bit of it and then send it off and then wake her up, and then we find out the results a few weeks later, which was an option. The other option was to try some medication, quite harsh medication for a rat, and the other option was to take her home, make her comfortable, and kind of let nature do its thing. But the decision I made was to let nature do its thing, because let's be fair, Remy was an old rat. She was about three and a half. I can't be certain on her age because I adopted her. It's the same as Holly. I don't know Holly's exact age because I adopted her. I just know that they are very old by the way they look and how long I've had them individually. So Remy I had for about 2.5 years, and when we got her, apparently they said she was roughly about 6 months old. That makes her about three and a half, give or take. I decided that instead of putting her through a load of crap where it'd mean taking her out of the cage, away from Daisy and Lola, going to the vets all the time, the stress, the journey, and putting her to sleep, the chances were, it was like a 50-50% chance that she'd live through the first, just the autopsy, let alone doing that and then medication and then having it removed, like, and the chance of it coming back. It's just higher, and it's not worth the pain you put your pet through. It's really not. Honestly guys, don't be selfish and think of yourself. This is the problem I had. I thought about myself so much, and I thought, well, if she dies, then I'm gonna be upset and I'm gonna miss my rat and I'm gonna be, but at the end of the day, it's whether they're comfortable, and would you put a human through that? Would you put yourself through that? That's what I thought in my head to help me through it. And that was the hardest bit, kind of accepting that I'm going to have to make this decision which ends her life, which I did make the decision. About a month after the vets, I took her to the vets twice for weigh-in and stuff, and it turns out that the tumour was actually taking all of her nutrition and nutrients and stuff, and she slowly became a fragile little thing. And you know, you could see her bones, and she was so fragile, like she was really struggling to move around the cage. And the tumour actually got to about the size of a tennis ball. I'm not even exaggerating. I could literally like feel it, and I felt at this point, this is just cruel to do this. Even though she was acting completely fine, and if she didn't have that tumour, I'm over 100% sure she would have lived for another year or two maybe. She was such a healthy rat. She was glowing, she was lovely, she bounced about. And you shouldn't have favourites, but she was my favourite because she was such a lovely rat. I taught her tricks, she knew her name, and she knew me, I knew her. That's how it was. And I knew her that she couldn't go on like this anymore. So I made the decision exactly 1 week after losing Latte. I lost Latte on a Friday, and Remy died the Friday after exactly. She had to be put to sleep. I made that decision, and it kills me every day because I'm the person that decided that, and now I have all these questions going on in my head saying, did you do the right thing? Should you have got it removed? Should you have put her on medication? But would it have been worth doing all of that? You really have to think about the animals over yourself sometimes. That's what happened to Remy. She passed away, bless her, and Lola and Daisy are doing fine together. So now I'm going to explain what happened to Pepper. Basically, Pepper was a massive shock. Like, it was so unexpected. It broke my heart completely. I got so sick of making the rest in peace videos. The last one that I made for Pepper, left it completely blank. Simple pictures of Pepper, and I just wanted to remember Pepper on my channel for one more time, because the reason I started Animal Palace was because I had Latte and the guinea pigs. I now don't have Latte and only have two guinea pigs. So they were the main reason, and now the Animal Palace is getting smaller and it's getting harder. It's just getting harder. Pepper was a massive shock. One day I went in to feed him and he was very lifeless in his litter tray where he normally slept. Just a disclaimer, I didn't leave him in a rotten litter tray. He liked to sleep in there because he was weird and I loved him. He was asleep in his litter tray and he was really lifeless. When I put the salad in, he didn't jump out to come and get it. I knew there was something wrong almost instantly because I've had him for 4.5 years. I know him very well. It poked him about a little bit, as you do, because I thought, oh my gosh, what's happening to him? And he was very motionless and lifeless and he didn't want to move. He was like fully awake. I knew he wasn't dead. He was just a bit lifeless in his belly, and his tummy wasn't like moving, so I quickly grabbed him out and I put him in a blanket and I laid him on the floor with me and I started stroking him just to make sure he was okay. And I thought maybe he's having an off day, because he has had off days before where he wouldn't eat or drink and he would just go like a day and then the next day he'd be fine, but nothing like this. And he was breathing quite quick. He didn't appear to be in pain. He was quite peaceful. He was just laying there. He was trying to move, but he had no use of his back end. And I noticed that he had his poo area was quite clogged, let's say. And so I cleaned it all out for him and I made him very comfortable. I made him warm. The decision was, it was a Friday night and there was no way I could get him to a vet's until Monday, unless I go to out of hours vets, which cost an absolute bomb. Have you guys ever gone to an out of hours vet? They charge like £150 just to see them. I don't have that kind of money. Like, I work as a carer. I'm not like a friggin' millionaire. And I love my animals dearly and I would do anything for them. So I did what I did best. And I made him very comfortable. I actually put him in bed with me. That's like how comfortable. How much more comfortable could you make a guinea pig? So I put him on my pillow with me and I was stroking him for ages. And I decided to put him back to bed with his brother, because George was probably wondering where he was. So I popped him back to bed. And the next morning he was kind of the same, but he seemed to have declined a little bit. And I spoke to my dad about it. And I kind of knew in myself and in my heart, I knew he was going to die. So I decided that the vets couldn't do anything for him, because it's gonna sound really odd trying to explain this, but you know, a guinea pig's tummy is quite like fat and firm. His tummy had completely, like, as if someone popped it and deflated, so I could feel every bone in his body. So I knew taking him to the vets, they wouldn't be able to do nothing for him, and I knew he wasn't in pain just by how he was. He was still eating lettuce when I gave it to him, and he still let me stroke him, and when I touched his nose, he'd still do that nudgy thing that he did, which was so cute. I loved that. And he'd nibble my finger like he normally does. I knew he wasn't in pain, and I knew I wasn't doing the wrong thing. You guys may think it's cruelty. You guys may think I did the completely wrong thing, but I decided to not take him to the vets. I decided, like any normal human being in my job, you see this every single day, every shift. Somebody dies on me normally, and they're at home with their family around them, comfortable. What is the better way to go than like that? So I decided to do the exact same for Pepper. I put him back in his cage, I made him comfortable, I gave him a clean surrounding, I cleaned his bottom, I made him comfortable, I put food near him, a pile of nuggets, I fed him water, syringed it in his mouth. He was fine. He was comfortable. I got him out every single day up until his last day. And he was very, very, very cold, breathing quick, completely lifeless. I knew in myself he was gonna pass away. And I knew it was that day. I had to go to work. And it was just a training meeting, but I had to go. It's completely compulsory. So what I did is I wrapped him in a blanket, and then I put him in his piggy pig pig's bed where he loved. And George was sleeping in the litter tray completely next to him, so they were together. And, you know, I gave him a kiss and I stroked him a little bit, and I put him back in the cage, and I locked the cage, and I went on my shift. When I come back, I literally ran home. Like, I don't think I've ever moved so quick to get home from work. And I opened the front door and I come in and, like, I ran, put my shoes off, put my stuff away. I ran into the back room. My mum, like, stopped me instantly, and she was like, you don't want to go in there. And I was just like, why? And it turned out he passed away without me. I don't know what he decided. I don't know if he decided that without me was the best way. He didn't want to do it with me there. He just waited maybe until I left, and he thought, you know what, I can go now. And he died with his brothers around him, in his cage, in his favourite bed, in his favourite spot, peacefully. And he looked so comfortable. My dad took him out and wrapped him in a blanket, ready for me to sort out, and I buried him in the garden. Latte, Remy and Pepper are all buried in the same area. And in the summer, we're going to put marigolds down, flowers. I've got wind chimes and windmills to put down, and some really cute things that I'm going to put around there, which is going to be a different video, but in the summer, so you guys can see. This whole video is, it was my decision, what I did with my animals. I decided to do what I did, and yes, it breaks my heart, but there was nothing I could do about it. I knew they were going to die. You can't hold on to these things forever, and you can't do something because it makes you happy. You've got to do something that's going to make them happy and put them out of pain. So consequently to this, I to cheer myself up, because I'm quite unmotivated to make videos at the moment, I decided to make another channel, which the channel link will be down below. It's with my sister, and we've decided to make a channel about the world, everything colourful, makeup, hair tutorials, routines, just a normal channel about everything. I'm gonna still continue with the Animal Palace. I feel like I need a little break. But if you have got any requests, can you please leave them down below? I read every comment I get, so, and I tend to reply to almost every comment, so it would be really nice if you guys could request some new videos for me to do that aren't depressing. And I'm very sorry that my videos have been depressing. I can't help what's happened. All my animals have grown old at the same time, and you're probably all wondering, no, I won't be getting any more guinea pigs, I won't get another rabbit, and I'm not going to get any more rats. This is another reason for my new channel.